Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're actually talking about a newer release from Best Tech Knives out of China. So one of these higher-end Chinese-made brands like Riyadh, Kaiser Knives, Wee Knives, and so on. And this is one of a collaboration series that Best Tech has done with the Polish designer Grzegorz Grabarski, which calls himself Kombu, that's his nickname. And he has a very interesting design language, really a lot of millings in the handles, lots of interesting overall form factor. And this is one of the more EDC friendly or more slender overall designs that Mr. Grabarski has actually done for Best Tech, and that's also why it was most interesting to me. He did a lot of 4-inch bladed knives, and you know I'm more in the medium to small range of knives for things that I like to own and carry, so those put me a little bit off, but this one here is very interesting, and we're of course talking about his Vibra model. And you can see right here, very interesting overall design, really modernistic design, lots of milling on the handle and pocket clip right there, also on the back spacer, and you can really tell that's a Kombu design. If you take a look at the website of Best Tech or on the Instagram site of Kombu himself, everything will be linked in the description below, as well as my Instagram handle, which is 7ready_knife_reviews, and I would be very happy if you could follow me there as well. As you know, you can get some sneak peeks there for upcoming video content on the Instagram. But this knife right here really is very interesting in the overall design. You also get a slender opening hole, also some milling around there. Interesting, like turbine looking pivot. And just a very interesting overall design here from Best Tech and Kombu. Let's start off with the specs as always. So here on the Best Tech knives Vibra, we have an overall length of just at 8 inches or 20.3 centimeters. With a blade length of 3.5 inches or 8.9 centimeters. This one here has an updated steel for Best Tech, which is M390, as you can see right here. And there is the Kombu logo as well. And then we have a blade stock thickness of 3.8 millimeters, so a little bit thicker than you would think for a slender, smaller knife that this one is right here. And then we get a handle length of 4.625 inches or 11.75 centimeters. So certainly great in hand. You know, I have a small to medium hand wearing a 7.5 sterile glove, and you can see my hand fits perfectly well here on this knife. I can even choke back a little bit. Of course, there's no forward finger choil or anything, but really comfortable in the hand here. You can feel some of these chamfers or scallops here in the back of the handle when you really bear down, or also when you're actually flicking the knife repeatedly. This area right here can get a bit sore in the hand. Just this little edge right there that is raised where the screw goes in. But other than that, really comfortable in the hand. You also have some jimping here on the spine. Not a lot, not a long run of jimping there, but it certainly fits very well and is also functional. You also get that little dip down here on the handle with a little bit of a scallop. So feels really comfortable here in this regular kind of saber grip. Very, very comfortable here for my hand size. In terms of weight, we're looking here at only 90 grams or 3.17 ounces, and that's also because they have done some internal milling on these titanium scales. You can see right here, nice internal milling on both sides, and that's really quite an achievement for a 3.5-inch blade, all titanium, pretty thick titanium skirts, and also a full titanium backspacer, as well as 3D milled clip to get the weight in at only 90 grams or 3.17 ounces. So that's certainly very well done. Price wise here on the Vibra, we're looking at $255 for this knife for titanium, of course running on ceramic ball bearings, captured ball bearings, as well as a ceramic detent with a steel lock bar insert with an oval travel prevention device. And of course, we're getting the M390 steel here on this particular model. Of course, with these Best Tech folders, you also get a lot of different versions. So you can have bronze anodized handles, gray handles, satin finished blades, stonewashed blades, as well as this darker stonewash or blackwash finish that I have here on this one. Also like that, if you go with that, you get the matching blacked out hardware, and you can see there is not a lot of hardware on this knife, especially on the presentation side. I really like you got the very nicely decorative pivot screw right there with that nice milling turbine looking theme there, and just one blacked out Torx screw. And on the other side, you of course get your tooled pivot as well as the screw in the back, one screw for the pocket clip and one for the lock bar insert. There you can also see the over travel stop, and that's it. So very, very minimal overall hardware for a larger knife, and I certainly like that. Really loving how they have done the backspacer to tie in with all that milling. Really well done there. Also, disengaging the lock bar here is very easy. You can see that here. They have a slightly raised lock bar. They have a nice chamfer there. No jimping or anything, but very easy to disengage that lock bar. And in the closed position, you can also see that everything ties together really well. So it's nicely designed here. Nothing exposed, not an exposed tang or anything. Also, the flipper tab really integrates very well with the overall design. So not sticking out a lot, not going to cause any issues in the pocket, because the handle dips down and kind of incorporates the flipper tab in that overall arc you get from the knife itself. So that's certainly really well done here by Best Tech and Combu. And if you take a look at the pocket clip, we can see here nicely contoured and textured pocket clip, good ramp, good amount of springiness, not massive clearance there. So if you have very thick reinforced pocket seams, that can be an issue, but on my pockets it worked actually quite well. Also carried about like this, so a little bit more protruding from the pocket that I would like, because you have this slender kind of handle in the end there, or at the end of the handle. I would love to see the pocket clip going up a bit and being mounted really on the utmost end of the handle scale, so only a little bit is sticking out, so a little bit higher carry than I would prefer, but certainly not extremely high. It still carries very well, and because it's slender, pretty lightweight, and has the nice overall design of the flipper tab, it actually carries really well, and you don't have any issues reaching past it. Now let's do our overall size comparisons you like to see here on the channel. So we have the Best Tech Vibra, then we have our standard Shirogorov Sandwich F95NL at the top and Neon Zero at the bottom. And you can see it is very close to a Neon Zero, a slight bit larger overall than the Neon Zero, as you can see right there, but certainly quite a bit smaller than an F95NL. Then we do our benchmark EDC comparisons as well. We have the full-size Benchmade Bugout at the top with Allen Putman aftermarket micarta scales, and then we have the Para 3 by Spyderco with Sharp Dressed Knives aftermarket scales here as well. And you can see it's certainly larger than both of these knives. If you take a look at a thickness comparison, we can see blade stock is pretty similar to a Para 3. Also, overall handle thickness is also quite close to a paramilitary 3. You can see that here. Of course, there will be areas where it's a little bit thicker and where it's a little bit thinner because of all the milling and the overall contouring of these titanium scales. But it certainly feels very nice and hand-feeling, not overly thick, just right where you want it to be. When you're holding a knife in your hand as well as when you're carrying it. So certainly not overly thick or cumbersome to carry in my experience. Then we have some other competitive options. For example, we have a US made knife, the ZT-0609, the best ZT knife ever made in terms of full production ZTs in my opinion. And you can see that it is slightly longer than the 0609. In terms of ergonomics, I would probably give it to the 0609. It's also a bit more slender and everything is rounded a bit more in terms of the milling on the handle. Maybe you can see that here. You got more abrupt edges and turns and things like that on the Vibra in comparison to the more rounded down milling here on the 0609. That's certainly something to keep in mind there, but certainly not sharp, but you can just feel the transitions on those millings, especially the deeper ones. That is something, just the fact that there is a step there, that is something you certainly can notice, but I really appreciate the milling. It just looks so nice. We still get an external lock bar cutout, which I certainly would like to see on the inside there. You can see there is no interference with the pocket clip and the lock bar cutout. And they have even milled inside the lock bar cutout these lines. So it's really an impressive feat of engineering here, all the milling that has been incorporated in this handle of the Vibra. Then some other competitive options could be this one here. This is an MDD-K from Wingman EDC with the Lee Williams kickstop mechanism. And in terms of size, you can see this one is also smaller than a Vibra, and it's probably also going to be a bit thicker because of the heavily contoured scales right there. Also, blade stock is a bit thicker on the MDD-K, and overall certainly a more toned down design language. And the last thing I have for you is the ProTech Malibu. Great flipper in the collection, certainly something a bit different in overall approach. Also a US made knife here, the Malibu, but you can see the Malibu is also slightly smaller. We have a little bit of similarity there in how the blade is designed. Of course, once again, a bit toned down, so you're getting a lot of machine work, a lot of design features here on the Vibra. And that is something you have to like. If you like more toned down designs, something very basic, for example, like the Neon Zero, for example, this one might be a bit overboard for you. But if you like these very intricately milled and textured titanium handles, a very interesting executed blade there, lots of things to look at and to experience, I think the Vibra is certainly a good option for you. As I said before, very comfortable in hand, nice flat grind, and for how thick it starts, it actually gets down to a very respectable thickness behind the edge. It thicks up from there a bit because you have to get back to that thicker blade stock of 3.8 millimeters, but in regular EDC use, it hasn't held me back. And because you get a good length of 3.5 inches, you actually can do pretty much everything you would like to do with a EDC blade. Tip thickness is also nice and thin, so great for piercing, getting into packaging that is very well executed with this modified Warncliffe blade, I would call it. Really, really good looking, and the action on the Vibra is actually very well executed. My particular model has a bit of a light detent, so I can half open it if I want to. So you can see this one has a bit of a lighter detent. I don't know if all the Vibras are like that, but that is something I noticed, especially in comparison with the stronger detent I have experienced with this one here, which is the medium-sized reticulum. This one certainly has a stronger detent than the Vibra, and certainly one of the strongest detent I felt on a Bestech. So I was a bit surprised that there is that big of a difference between these two models that came out along the same time. But the nice thing about that is that you can easily spider flick it with that smaller slot style hole that you get here. So very, very comfortable to do that, easy to do. You can also open it with your thumb as well with that opening slot, so that's certainly a great thing. You have a lot of fidget factor because of the slightly lighter detent that we have here on the Vibra, but it's certainly something to keep in mind. It's perfectly centered, also blade to handle ratio, and how they used every last little bit of that handle for the blade is done very well here. As you can see, it doesn't look very off balance, so they did a great job there. and just overall a very interesting design and probably the most EDC friendly of the combo designs so far. So for that matter, I'm actually quite impressed with the Vibra, especially featuring M390 and all the milling and lighting pockets. I think you're getting quite your money's worth here with the 255 price tag. If you prefer a stronger detent, more of a mainly flipper geared overall knife, I think if all Vibras are like this one here, that could be something that could hold you back. But if you like the versatility that the Vibra brings you with the Spidey Flick, thumb flick, flipper deployment, which is mostly a light switch, as well as the ability to open it slowly and control it, I think that is could also be seen as a positive point here on the Vibra and how it was executed right here. One thing that I always like about Best Tech is that you have a lot of different options in terms of the finishing of these knives. This one certainly looks great with the blue and the black. Very, very nicely done. Also, the milling and chamfering inside that opening hole is done really well. All the grinds are nice and symmetrical. I probably would have gone for a slightly thinner blade stock there. But other than that, if you like these nicely milled and heavily designed folders, I think the combo designed Best Tech Vibra is a great option. And certainly one of his more EDC-able designs. And I'm really glad that I could check this one out here. Nice in the hand, quite comfortable. Some of these ridges you can feel a little bit more, especially if you really dig it into your hand while deploy it. You can feel the top edges here a little bit. This area right here could be rounded a bit more. This here can be a bit sharp. But that's pretty much the only thing that caused me some discomfort while manipulating this knife. When you have it in hand like this to actually do some work, it's very, very comfortable with the handle design. So I hope you could get a good feel for the overall knife. Certainly an interesting design here by Combo and Best Tech. And if you like it, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, put them down in the comments below. Please check out White Mountain Knives and use my discount code 7ready to get 10% off your entire order. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews and follow me here on YouTube. So thanks again for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.